We know the difficulty of not being able to travel freely this interview season, and we want to make sure that every applicant to an ophthalmology residency has the ability to find out all they can about a residency program. Here at UTMB, we are creating this video so that you get a better understanding of our program and see if it's the right fit for you.
This is a university eye clinic, and I'm going to show you around our new and improved wet lab. We recently bought a new Zeiss microscope to use, as well as we have a new Bausch & Lomb phaco emulsification machine. We can practice suturing on the pig eyes, we can practice capsule rexus, phaco emulsification, and it really does simulate the real world. Walk into our surgical simulating room, which is where our IC machine is. And this is where we start training, even as first years, and where we really get a good grasp on our dexterity and hand stability while working inside the eye. We can spend anywhere from 5 to 10 hours a week working on IC. And I think this is a really key aspect to our surgical training here as well. So this is our main lobby. Now I'm going to show you around our University Eye Clinic, which is our main clinic here in Galveston. Today we have retina in this hallway, but on any given day we can have cornea, pediatrics, oculoplastics, or general ophthalmology. Let me show you into one of our clinic rooms. So here we have our typical clinic room. So we have everything we need, including refraction. We have all our tools. We have our slit lamp. We have an indirect. So in the clinic, we have a variety of different tools, including our Topcon fundus photo camera. We also have an OCT. We also have a fluorescein angiogram that's right across the hallway. But we do use these very frequently, especially in our glaucoma and retina clinics. So this is our minor procedure room. And in this room, we do mainly a lot of oculoplastic surgeries. We have a microscope, epilation machine for eyelashes. All right, so next we're gonna walk into our resident lounge, which is where these residents spend a good amount of time in here. So we have here, four computers and dividers. So usually we'll come here and do research on weekends. Many of our residents live off of the island. And so when they do have to take call, it's convenient for them to stay here. And several residents have slept on the couch before for their call nights, and they're pretty comfortable. We have pillows and blankets.
So we are in the main hallway of Jenny Seeley right now. Our operating rooms are just through this door here. This is one of our phaco machines. This is the Bausch & Lomb Stellaris Elite. We also have the Centurion back over here. So our retina faculty like to use the Stellaris. Here we have the Centurion. For our phacos, we tend to use this a little bit more, but you obviously can use Stellaris as well if that's what you're interested in. Moving along here, different opto equipment. Since this is a primary operating room that we operate out of, most of all of our stuff is right in here. And then over here, we have our various IOLs that we use for surgery. So quite a wide variety. You can see a lot over here. Even if there is a specialty lens, a premium IOL that you might be interested in implanting. If we don't have it here, we have great relationships with the various reps for the companies, and as residents, you can get some of those to implant as part of your training and essentially make it free to the patient as well. So we're just in the physician break room. It's actually pretty nice. They got some comfortable chairs, TV, area to make some food, some snacks. So pretty nice facilities to have.
All right, so we are in the surgical workroom right now. Plenty of computers in here. You can come up either between cases, while you're waiting on a case, anything like that, to do whatever computer work you may need to do, get the charts ready, anything like that.
So we're now heading towards Texas Department of Corrections, also known as Hospital Galveston. And we'll be going through the security process next, which includes scanning your ID badge first and then going through two sets of double doors. So we're at the eye clinic at the Texas Department of Corrections. The TDC hospital is a catchment area, meaning that we get prisoners from all over Texas. Their commute times can vary, can go from anywhere between 2 to 3 hours to several days, so it's a true privilege serving them. Each block, our TDC team has 3 residents, a first year, a second year, and a third year, each having their own eye exam rooms. We have an amazing group of nurses who work patients up before we see them. We have an amazing group of officers to maintain safety and security for us. The TDC Eye Clinic is a primarily resident-run clinic. We have our own equipment present, so this is our IOL master. Each eye room is equipped with slit lamps, fluoropters, indirect ophthalmoscopes. We're able to perform fundus photos on our patients ourselves. So this is our third eye exam room where we have our own OCT machine. The good thing about this is that we're able to operate and perform OCTs ourselves, which is a great skill to have as a resident. So we're at the entrance of the emergency department where we have our own eye exam room. This is the eye exam room where we see our ER patients. We have our slit lamp, fluoropter, indirect ophthalmoscope, as well as several eye instruments. We also have our own B-scan in the closet. So we're at the Jenny Seely Hospital, where most of our inpatient consults come from. We have our own eye exam room on this unit with our own portable slit lamp. We're able to take this portable slit lamp to our patient rooms and perform our eye exams there.
Welcome over to our Leak City OR. This is where we have all our outpatient surgeries taking place in the Leak City area. It's a great opportunity for ophthalmology residents to come out here to see surgical cases. We get to scrub in, we get to experience shorter turnaround times, we get to work closely with the scrub techs, kind of get a sense of what an outpatient surgical center is like on a day-to-day basis. This is where we do all of our OR surgical cases.
Morning.
This is Lance. He's one of our senior ophthalmology residents. So ophthalmology will operate in different rooms, but generally when you're operating with Dr. Wong, who's our oculoplastic surgeon, you'll operate in OR room number 5. So this is kind of our home base. So this is our OR suite. We've got our Centurion base for cataract surgery right here. We've got all the access to our microscopes. We'll generally fix our PD right here and get ready for surgery. We usually bring up kind of to help our techs do all our gloves and gowns. It makes it really helpful if we all work together as a team. So it's really nice to have that backup in our ORs here. So here, this is where we do our basic notes, operating notes, get all of our medicines in for the patients, get everything ready and set up for them to get going home after the procedure. And once that's done, we go and talk to the patient. So once our cataract cases or any ophthalmology procedure is finished, we typically come out here with our faculty and we will go over a patient's case with the patient's family. We let them know how things went and what to expect over the next coming days. And so we have special consultation rooms that allow us to do that.
All right, so this is our Victory Lakes Clinic, and this is a patient room with all the amenities that come with a standard patient room, a fluoropter, a slit lamp, an indirect lamp in the back. And this is our imaging room here. We have an OCT where we take a look at images of the macula as well as fundus camera. And over here we have our Humphrey visual field as well as our eye wall master. Right, so we're about to head over to the new ophthalmology area where we have big plans. So this is the future ophthalmology suite.
We hope that you have enjoyed visiting us and that you have a better idea of our program and some of the unique characteristics and educational opportunities that we work to provide our residents in order to give them the best educational experience possible. Should you have any questions or wish to contact us, please email our residency coordinator through the website link and we will be happy to speak with you further. Best of luck.